Tonight's screencast is on rocks, the basics. Please take notes in your notebook as you watch this screencast. For igneous rocks, we talked about today, the vocabulary that's important is melting, solidification, magma and lava, intrusive, and extrusive. Igneous rocks form underground with high heat and pressure. We talked about how magma is liquid rock underground. And when intrusive rocks cool underground, they cool really slowly. And they cool inside the earth. They're called intrusive rocks. This can take a really, really long time, anywhere from hundreds of thousands to millions to even billions of years. And when this happens over a really long period of time, the crystals become large, they have a long time to grow, and they're considered to have a coarse texture, kind of like the granite that's shown here in this picture. Each of these little particles, you know, the black and white parts are the grains. When it reaches the Earth's surface, it changes from being magma and it turns into what we call lava. And since it has exited the Earth's surface, it's considered extrusive. This happens quickly. It can happen in, you know, a matter of minutes or even seconds if lava hits water, like with an underground volcano, or in lava flows, you know, it could cool in a matter of minutes, hours, or days. All right. Now, since it cools so quickly, the rock crystals are really small. They don't have very much time to form. So you can go from, you know, not being able to see the grains to have them be glassy or fine. Now, with igneous rocks, the texture depends on basically its area of formation. Now, one thing that I didn't mention here is the vesicular rocks, like the pumice that I showed you in class today. Vesicular means that it has gas pockets, and it almost looks like Swiss cheese. Now, igneous rocks are formed by magma. There's two different types of magma. Mafic magma is dark, and it'll create basalt. Okay, and it is very dense. It has a dark color, and it's rich in iron and magnesium. Picture of it looks like that. Felsic magma is much lighter in color, lower in density, and it's considered felsic in its composition, and it's rich in silicon and aluminum. Okay, and it would create a granite that looks like that. Sedimentary rocks, the vocabulary that we want to make sure we identify with sedimentary rocks are deposition, burial, compaction, and cementation. There's three different types of sedimentary rocks that we discussed in class today. Clastic rocks form from fragments. Clastic means fragment of other rocks. Some examples are sandstone and conglomerate. The conglomerate is like the one that the sample I showed you that I got at Slide Mountain when I was climbing there. Chemical rocks are evaporites. They form when minerals are left behind when water evaporates. An example is like rock salt. And organic sedimentary rocks come from the remains of plants and animals. So clastic sedimentary rocks look like this. This was like the rock I showed you in class. You can see my mouse is hovering over the fragments, the clasts. Okay. This is a sample of rock salt. You can actually see the little clusters of salt. This is left behind after water evaporates. And I put two pictures of organic sedimentary rocks. One on the left, you can clearly see the fossil imprints, okay, showing that's a sedimentary rock because fossils are only found in sedimentary rocks. The picture on the right is someone shoveling coal. Coal is the remnants of plants and animals that lived between 3 and 400 million years ago in the Carboniferous period. Metamorphic rocks are the last type of rocks. Their vocabulary associated with that is heat, pressure, mineral alignment, banding, and regional metamorphism and or contact metamorphism. Now, metamorphic rocks show mineral alignment or banding, and this is due to the heat and pressure separating the different minerals due to their density differences. And the example I showed you in class was a metamorphic rock called gneiss, and you can see here clearly, this is a small sample of gneiss, and you can see the lines in it show the banding. Okay, metamorphism can happen in two different ways. One is regional. This is a large-scale metamorphic event. This is like when an entire mountain chain is pushing down on the rocks below it. Okay, this causes a large area of metamorphic rock and often causes the hardest types of metamorphic rock, like gneiss. Contact metamorphism, however, is just a small area. And this is when magma pushes through layers in the rock and basically sears the edges of the rock that it touches. Now, an important thing with metamorphism is that the original rock cannot melt. If it does melt, it's an igneous rock. So metamorphic rocks do encounter high temperatures, but they're not hot enough to melt. Now, in summary, we want to use a variety of study strategies. We want to use flashcards to study. We want to draw the rock cycle from memory. And we want to use T-charts. So, to summarize, rocks are classified by their origin, mineral content, and texture. As I spoke about in class, rocks are constantly recycled by crustal dynamics. As shown in this diagram to the right, this is a basic rock cycle diagram. It shows that there's no beginning or end. Rocks are constantly recycled by the Earth. So this is a basic overview of the rock types. I hope you got some good notes out of this. If you need to watch it again, please do that. And be prepared to come into class tomorrow and identify some basic rock types. Good luck.